Hello again, guys. We're here at Guitar Guitar Digital. Ray, I'm here with Simon from Ableton, and he's going to show me about sampling on Ableton Live using the new Push 2, because I don't know how to do it.
Okay. Simon, let's have a look.
Let's have a look.
Okay, so the first thing with Push 2 is obviously got this lovely display, and what better way to use it is get some waveforms and samples on it.
Let's do it.
What I'm going to do, I'm going to add a track. And straight away now the browser's changed, you've got previews, you can look through everything. And where you've normally got places on Live9's browser here,
sure,
you can access your own samples. So we've got a folder in here called samples that we added before. So if you come across here, I mean you can come and have a look a little bit closer there. Under user files now, straight away I can get access to the samples folder.
Oh, brilliant.
So I can go straight into here, just give you an idea. You've got a processed folder here with some amen breaks and stuff,
wow,
of course.
Wow.
So you can listen to these, those are individual.
That's a new thing as well, it gives you a lot of samples straight away.
Yeah, you can preview. You can turn a preview on and off there.
That's already cool.
But you know, let's keep it on.
Yeah.
So you can go through there. So what I'm doing, I'm just going to show you. I'll load a drum break that's kind of sampled from vinyl, a classic break,
nice,
which a lot of people are asking for. And I'll just show you, you can cut it up and slice it. So let's have a look at that. So we'll go straight in here, we've got some drum samples, and a classic there, Bob James. So now you can listen back to those, you hit load, and this now loads it into the simpler. So this is Live 9.5, and this is the redesigned simpler, which allows time stretching, and you've got three different modes. So the first one we'll look at is the slicing mode. But first of all, you can, if you look, you can zoom into the sample. I'll try and take like the first couple of bars to make it easier.
So is this exactly what's happening on the background?
Yeah, pretty much this is replicated. If you're just using 9.5,
sure,
and this is all versions, you've now got a nice little button there.
Nice.
But this is helpful to know. If you hit the button, and you can now resize that as big as you want, which is great if you're working on all different sizes of screens, especially on a laptop, and you can now zoom in. The waveforms themselves have been improved. If you zoom right in there, the detail, really cool. You can see
this
every
is good for folks who have a push, right?
They
display.
For guys that don't have push, perfect. And we have one in front
of
us. Let's have a look.
Okay,
so you can zoom in. I'll try and keep my hands so you can see what's going on. So I'm just going to bring the end of the sample in there. And it's all about the sample engine. It's warping samples. So if I kind of go in there, it's already got an idea. Play this around here, and I'm just gonna bring the end in. Right, I'm gonna go for that. So with this, if I hit sample there.
Can I size it as well?
Yeah, so if I go in there, I'm using, if I hit warp there, warp is on, and I've got the usual warp modes, beats, tones, complex pro, everything there. So it gives you the chance to customize your samples, play the higher pitches, lower pitches, keeping the same timing, which is all about the time stretching. So it's kind of taking sampling that next stage further, where you can play different pitches and you're keeping it at the same time.
Awesome.
So
tempo, yeah.
Yeah, so with a break, for example, you can play it across different octaves. You can give it this kind of, it's got extra depth. If I turn the warp off, just this is kind of pre-Live 9.5, and try the same thing. You know,
instant
sounds terrible.
There we go.
Yeah, well, if some people want that vibe, but you've got it, you can switch it on and off. So with that on, everything's locked in nice and tight. So I mean, that's with a drum beat, but if you, I'll show you some melodic stuff afterwards, right? You can kind of play pitches up and down, re-pitch instruments, and it sounds good and very usable. So with that there, I've got this break there, and what I'm doing now, I'm going to go back into the main simpler controls, and you've got three modes. You've got classic, which you can, you know, play chromatically up and down the keyboard, and it's going to time stretch. One shot is literally for something that's going to, you hit it, it plays it through its entirety.
You mean like a speech or something like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, a speech or a bass drop or anything that's just a one shot. So, you know, it's used for all kinds of things. And then you've got slicing. This is where people like this, because you can grab any sample from the browser, from within your arrangement, from session view, just drag it straight into simpler and then instantly slice it up. So by default, I'll just zoom in there. It's gone for the transients, which are all the different hits there. You've got your orange lines.
Tallest part of a waveform, right?
Yep, all that. So if I press the sensitivity, I'll get, grab the pen, put sensitivity, bring it down. You can bring those boxes to less boxes. So you can have little, you know, sort of longer. So it's going to play each one to the end there, you can change that too, but if I increase sensitivity, obviously it's slicing this even more precise. So. And if you want to, you can just nudge the end of the previous sample there, you can sort of change, this is all kind of why you're getting your ideas down, because this is all from one instance of simpler. You can change the sensitivity, and if you want to be a little bit more specific or creative with those, rather than allow the transients, you can turn sensitivity to zero, and then you can activate pad slicing. Now, pad slicing allows you to slice a sample wherever you want. If I hit delete there, I can get rid of any samples, any sort of pads sliced already. So if I hit this now, as soon as I press play, I can tap any pad anywhere on the push to buttons there, and it will slice when I say. So if I can, if I just tap here, so I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, I'm going. Tap it faster like that. So obviously you could do that with some precision. You could, if you did it with an a cappella, you could play it every word phrase. So now I've got. So you see there, there's a little bit, I'm catching the next bit on. This is all within one. Simpler, as I said before, so we're going to slice this up shortly. So if I just do this, you can move that and you can just nudge it just to kind of control that one. So I'll select that there, and now I've got the. So, as I said, this is all in simple. When you've got it to some kind of shape, you want to experiment with it. If I hit layout now, it gives me the chance to try and sequence some of it as well. So if I do this, I can just draw a sequence in. So I can do that, but what most people like to do is slice each one of these into a separate simpler to make a drum rack. So all you do here is you hit convert, and then it says convert this to a drum rack, you hit that, and then pretty much instantaneously, however many of those are, so 16, 17 slices, and this is the new great thing about the push as well. If I go into mix, which is I can see the mixer. Across the top here, you've got number 3, there's a little logo there which shows drum rack. Previously, on the old push, you couldn't access the groups or unfold the channels. If I hit this now, you can unfold the channels. And if I play along here, you can see each slice is visible in the mixer. You've got these nice new meters which show peak and RMS. And so if I want to apply effects to any of these slices, I just select the slice and then I could go add device, and you can process each individual slice. So there's a lot to go at there.
That's loads. That's loads.
So much. I'll just show you one of the melodic melodic samples, so you can see what that's like. So I'll just hit browse. I'll go over the top of that. So into my user files, into this samples folder. We'll go so it's more melodic. I'll just choose the one I was demonstrating earlier. So I've chose this one because it's got a beat and it's got like a saxophone and how it works. And you know, we all like a bit of hip hop or something where you pitch it down and So I hit device, I've got this sample again, and I'm just gonna zoom in, just get it. I'll just play the first part actually. It's already got an idea of the tempo. Go into there, and it allows me to show the warp a little bit more as well. So I'm hitting warp, and this I'll show you the difference between when you use a complex mode. As you play things higher and lower, you know, you're going to get some kind of artifacts appear in the samples. So when you use the different modes, you can kind of smooth those out a little bit. So I've got it currently in beat, so. So when I play down low here, change the warp mode to Complex Pro, which Complex Pro is better for more complex music, literally different layers. It could have bass, it could have melodic instruments and drums. So it's kind of, if you're going to use pre-recorded stuff, it's a good one to use. You've got things like this now, where you've got, that's the original pitch, play here. Kind of create harmony. So depending melodically, if I use the scale and put it into chromatic so I can have access to every key. But you can imagine a solfege can do. So what originally was this. Yeah, so kind of think of it as any sound that you've got on your computer. You can obviously sample from anywhere, from vinyl. Once you've got it into your computer, you can put it into here, you can slice it, you can time stretch it, anything you want to do really.
Destroy it, new music.
Including your own samples as well. You can record straight into a clip, and then you can just send it straight to Simpler, convert it into a drum rack, and it's up to you and your creativity really.
It's not all that complicated either, is it?
No, slight learning curve. Anything good is usually, a little bit of a learning curve, but once you get past that, it's amazing.
Simon, thank you very much.
No worries, good stuff, man. Thanks.